You know the opening of Mala 3, even just like the first two bars?
Yeah, I think. Yeah, let's see.
Yeah, just do that much and twice as loud. Yeah, that was a little bit louder. Like, really.
Yeah.
Like, louder than maybe is appropriate.
Cool.
Even for this excerpt. You definitely have not gotten inappropriate yet.
Yeah.
I'm warmed up enough. But I want you to really, like, make it rattle. Mostly I want it so I can watch what happens.
Yeah.
Really lots of thick air. Note the E and just do like a long tone, like crescendo. Actually, don't worry about diminuendo. Just start soft and get loud. Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah. Okay, when you take your breath in, you're filling up here really well. So maybe think about filling up a little bit lower and to the back.
Mm.
A little bit, I see, and I'd love to see like expanding like forward, back, sides, the whole thing.
Yeah.
This is definitely expanding. And you're getting enough air in, but I think you'd feel less tense. Making sure it goes down and not pulling that way. But you're still set on the top lip. Yeah. One more time. And when you release it, don't collapse. It looks a little bit like...
Yeah.
Like, oh, how'd you get rid of that much air so fast? It makes me think that you're not filling up as much as just moving.
You're totally right. That's...
So don't move more than the air is moving you.
Mm-hmm. Gotcha.
Yes.
Hmm.
Yeah, that's
yeah.
The sound I was looking for. All right, play that opening one more time. So the other thing is, like, are you going marching?
No.
But you probably, when you're standing and doing, like, jazz, right?
That's
can you hold it up higher then?
This is, I've been doing this recently, trying to create that floating sensation.
Yeah.
And,
I mean, there's nothing wrong with it.
Mm.
I just, my arm gets tired watching.
Yeah, totally. It's tiring. So I've been experimenting with
this. Yeah, so just make sure that it doesn't build tension in your shoulders. So you might just like, yeah, right? Like, oops.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You know, just every once in a while, you might just like, oh, okay. If everything is hanging,
yeah,
then you'll feel more of the like, because if everything's up, you're going to have to work more just to expand just because you're already working more. So if you kind of let the horn hang, you even have a strap, right? So it can really hang. And try to avoid the... Like the accordion, like right? We don't need to do that. We can just using this to push the air out rather than
gotcha
squeezing it with our arms.
Yeah, so that's using the air,
yeah,
and not other.
Right. No, that was a great sound.
Yeah.
It's real like, so I want, instead of forcing the air out that way, I want you to force it out.
Yeah.
From there.
Yeah.
Rather than
gotcha.
From your shoulders.
Used to playing like like this, but it's a...
Right. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so, can you just, without even playing a note, just... That was better. Mm. So I want to see this go out a little bit more when you breathe in. Mm. Better. It's not just about pot belly, not pot belly, but definitely dropping this and letting this expand will help with the support.
Yeah.
So you need both.
Yeah.
This is what I've come to realize. There's not, it's not one or the other, it's both. But I think you could get a little more of expanding on the inhale and then using that to push the air out from the bottom rather than from the top.
I see.
Like,
yeah.
Like it's a humongous candle that you have to blow out.
Gotcha.
Still, yeah. It looks a little bit more like...
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So a little deeper. Yeah, now just more like you're blowing through a straw. Yeah.
Mm.
Put your hand back there so I can see it. Yeah.
Mm.
Wow, I felt that here.
Good.
That was the first time I felt that. Yeah, okay. So now play the beginning of that and avoid that drop.
Yeah.
I sound like poke. Like you're trying to avoid the ooh.
Yeah.
Like somebody's about to punch you. Yeah, and it's a good sound. I mean, the most important thing is the sound.
Mm.
If the sound works and you feel comfortable,
yeah.
It doesn't have to be exactly what I'm describing, right? Because
mm-hmm.
everyone's different. So as long as you don't feel like you're squeezing,
yeah.
And you're getting a nice big open sound. It doesn't have to look exactly like me.
Yes.
Everyone is built slightly differently. But I think that was better for sure. That's a great sound.
Mm.
All right, so I want you to take it up high. That's why I want you to do this
yeah.
session. So.
Mm-hmm.
So two things, I think, still keeping a little bit thicker air as you blow and expanding a little bit lower. And the other thing is making sure this stays relaxed.
Mm.
So, you know, you have the air speed and you have the lip tension, right? And they have to find the balance depending on whether you're going for soft or loud or high, low. So when you're blowing really fast for loud, this has to be that much more relaxed.
Mm.
Otherwise, it's going to just stop the air and just be providing extra resistance here. This is not where you want the resistance.
Yeah.
You want just enough resistance to vibrate, but you should almost feel like your lips are just like, not here, but inside.
Yeah.
So just like, as the louder you get, the more it just opens up into the mouthpiece.
Mm-hmm.
I think right now you're holding it back a little bit.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So try it just, you know, if it completely dissolved, fine.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like find that edge.
Yeah.
But see how relaxed you can get the inside of the mouthpiece.
Yeah.
Anywhere in there.
Sure.
While I think it's fine generally to expand,
yeah.
Because you've isolated it so much to up here,
yeah.
Try to do the opposite
yeah.
temporarily as an exercise. Remind you. See if you can get that same feeling as you breathe. There. So see if you can go a little further.
Yeah.
To where it's no longer beautiful.
Gotcha.
Great.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, as soon as you put this up there, this is like, oh, I don't know why. It's like all of a sudden it's like, oh, that's what you wanted me to do.
Yeah, gotcha.
You know, you take it. Anything, whatever works.
Hmm.
If you can find a safe time in the day or a safe place where you feel comfortable enough to risk like sounding gross, basically, which you did not, by the way.
Mm.
That was still very lovely.
Mm.
So, you know, you're never going to push your dynamic range if you don't like spend a little bit of time past it. And that can be, you know, loud playing is hard because you think about the neighbors, you think about your roommates, you think about wherever you are, wherever you're practicing. There's always somebody where you're like, oh my God, they're going to be like, who is this loser? What is their problem? But then sometimes I just think about the trombone players and I'm like, dude, trombone players do that every day, no matter who's around. So just pretend you're them.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's like, finding that balance.
Yeah.
But yeah, that already sounds much better.
That's been my goal is to like, some other teachers have said, waste the air.
Yeah.
And I realize... I've been focusing a lot on like the vowels and the support and getting rid of tension that I've been afraid to take a full breath. Like
I think,
I feel like when I do that, so I don't know how to.
I think it's okay. I mean, in the end, I think it's fine for this to expand. You know, you don't want to necessarily look like you're a bodybuilder, right? And it's all here.
Yeah.
Roar. You know, you want it to be a little bit more of like a balloon expanding.
Yeah.
More like this should look like the shapes of your lungs expanding.
Yeah.
Rather than like, look at my pecs. Wasting the air is, I think, is a great reminder to blow.
Mm-hmm.
But it doesn't work if you don't relax this.
Mm-hmm.
Right? If you can waste the air all day long and if you're holding it back with your tension, then you're just gonna get a brittle sound.
Yeah.
You should feel it just opening up as you crescendo.
Yeah.
Like let's take a third space C and we'll just do like a long tone.
Mm-hmm.
With the diminuendo, just so you can feel it go opening and closing.
I thought it was like, you know.
Yeah, we can hold tension all sorts of places.
But this is
But I think this is a really common place to hold tension, and we don't think about it.
Exactly. I want to try one more like third space C.
Yeah.
With that crescendo, decrescendo, still that feeling.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is why I'm getting like caught in a knot is because what I'm thinking about support is that it's something that you're consciously doing, but it's a result of airflow, right?
Right. Some people are like, what do? You push out or do you pull in? I don't know.
Mm.
I just breathe in and then I am like controlling the airflow out.
Yeah.
Like that's what support is.
Mm-hmm.
It's no more than that.
Yeah.
It's not like you're countering the airflow or trying to like stop the, it's just the way that you're pushing the air out. Like that's support.
Yeah.
So. Yeah, good job. God. Mm. It's hard. Good. How about that trill?
Yeah, it feels really stuck.
It feels stuck, yeah. Which suggests two things to me. One, that you're squeezing a little bit here, a little bit too much at the aperture.
Yeah.
So that then everything is just like...
Yeah.
And so there's not enough flexibility. How are your trills generally?
I don't really practice in the last time.
You don't need them that often.
Yeah, that's yeah.
It's hard to keep them up when you're not if you're not a solo horn player.
I don't think I've ever had a trill, and I'd love to figure out. Just yeah. Like...
So, have you ever worked on a trill?
Mm-mm.
Okay.
Yeah.
So there's like the classic da di da di da da da. Which is great.
Yeah.
That's a great way just to practice moving between those partials.
Yeah.
But in terms of getting, so that's like a good first step. But in terms of, which I think you can do already, getting the trill to like, right away,
mm-hmm.
I like the Freudis method, which is to start, instead of starting slower and getting faster,
mm-hmm.
you start short,
mm.
but at speed.
Gotcha.
And then try to expand it.
Yeah.
So for this one. And then once that feels comfortable, so it's just a little flick. And then try to do five. So trying to get them longer and longer, but always so that it starts right away.
Gotcha.
And even if the yada yam is too hard in the beginning, you can just go. Just to get the
upper partial.
Bam. And then yada yam, yada yam. It's really just figuring out the little tiny lip flick.
It's
the best way I can describe what's going on there. It's like the smallest movement. Try to control it less.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Right. Like if you're controlling, it's never gonna be fast.
Yeah.
You just have to let it. And it's not always gonna speak when you're first working on it, even ever.
Yeah.
It's not ever 100% reliable, but because you were getting it, I think you were surprising yourself when you were getting it.
Yeah.
Perfect. It's just really a matter of just doing it a little bit every day.
Because what I was thinking is the air flowing. This was what I was talking about.
Yeah.
Whenever I move my fingers,
yeah.
I might start off with airflow on one note, but as soon as I move to another note, I lose that active
push.
That constant push in.
Yeah, and
I feel like I let go of that.
Well, sometimes it's like we try to release some of the sound because. Like unconsciously, we think that will make the change less audible.
Yeah, exactly.
But of course, it does the opposite.
Yeah.
But that's really common.
Yeah.
And because as you switch it, also you kind of almost have to blow through it.
Yeah.
So yeah, I mean, certainly actively, almost an extra little spin of air as you switch.
Yeah.
Especially if you've been holding a note for a while. That's so often, right? You hear a pop.
Yeah.
Because it's a release and then go.
Yeah.
Instead of, you almost have to, and it doesn't sound like a crescendo so much as it just sounds even, but you kind of have to crescendo with your air.
Yeah.
The other thing is make sure that your fingers are moving marcato, even while which I wasn't hearing this, but with that issue that you speak of, sometimes we start to move our fingers legato, like, because that's the sound we want.
Yeah.
But then all of a sudden we have, like, way too much time in between.
Yeah.
And then you're going to get that. The airflow is going to be interrupted because it's like, whoa.
Yeah.
Whereas it needs to be, this has to be instant.
I see.
So that there's no point where, like, or there's as little a time as possible where there's, like, which one is the air going into? Wait, the air is nowhere to go. Oh.
Yeah, yeah.
So, you know, just practicing, you know, like, what's one that actually, how about, like, the yada, how about that measure?
Okay.
Making sure that while your air and the notes are legato, the fingers are still marcato.
Mm. Fingers moving at a certain speed.
Mm. Yeah. That's like sometimes when you start to hear, it's because they're like, you can also practice the fingers, especially this. I picked this one because it's cross fingering.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
You can practice it just listening to your fingers, making sure there's exactly one change, one sound per change.
Mm.
So it's never put up, put up, put up.
I see.
Try it once. So I heard it going from the famous one, of course, the D D flat to the D natural.
Yeah.
Where it's like, come on.
Yeah.
So this one has to rise at the same time this one goes down.
Ah.
Right one. And I still hear it, come on.
Yeah.
One more time. Better. That was the best one.
Mmm, okay. Yeah, because you're right. So two vowels moving create two sounds if they're not. Yeah. Okay, cool.
And then that will make it sound bumpy.
Mmm.
All right, so now try playing that one more time.